愿大家平安。
Peace to everyone.
今天下午我们的讲题是藏在灵里的隐秘处。
And this afternoon our topic is hiding in a spiritual secret place.
当我们遇到危险、困难的时候
，When we encounter problems or danger，
当然我们想要躲起来。
The first thing we do is to hide.
比如说，如果现在下冰雹了，你在外面，你一定是马上找一个地方可以躲起来。
For example, if it is hailing right now, you'll be definitely finding a place to be sheltered from the hail.
如果有一天遇到战争啊，敌人的轰炸机、飞弹打在我们的城市里面，我们也听到广播，就要找防空洞躲起来。
If one day you happen to find yourself in a battle, then and with the warplanes flying above you dropping bombs, then the first thing you will do is to find a shelter.
那有时候累了，我们想躲在自己的家里休息。
And sometimes when we are tired, we just want to hide at home to rest.
人总想找一个安全的地方，自己可以安静躲起来。
We humans, we always want to find a quiet place to hide ourselves.
但是当我们遇到属灵的挑战、属灵的风暴的时候
，Yet when we encounter a spiritual storm,
我们可以躲在哪里呢
？Where can we hide?
遇到危险的时候
，In times of danger,
当这个世界好像没有地方可以躲的时候
，When there is no place on earth for you to hide,
你可以躲在哪里
？Where can you hide?
当任何一个地方都不能保护我们的时候
，When there is no place, no safe place for us，
圣经告诉我们
，The Bible tells us，
神是我们那一个最后可以躲起来的地方。
God is the final hiding place for us。
啊，这个是记载在诗篇三十二篇。
This is recorded in Psalms 32。
啊，诗篇的三十二篇。
Psalms 32。
第七节。
Verse 7。
诗篇三十二篇的第七节。
Psalms 32 verse 7。
你是我藏身之处，你必保佑我脱离苦难，你得救的乐歌四面环绕我。
7. You are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from trouble. You shall surround me with songs of deliverance.
这里是告诉我们，神是我们那个我们可以躲起来的属灵的隐秘的地方。
So here this verse tells us that God is our spiritual hiding place.
任何危险，任何的灾难，只要你躲在神里面，都没有办法影响你。
And whatever calamity, whatever disasters that you encounter, as long as you're hiding in the Lord, you are safe.
到底神怎么样成为我们的躲藏的地方
？So how did God become our hiding place?
我们要讲几点。
We're going to raise a few points.
第一点
，First，
神让我们在灾害当中躲藏起来。
And God allowed us to hide from disasters.
这第七节。我们再读啊，这里说神是保佑我们脱离苦难的神。
And verse 7, that you shall preserve me from trouble.
啊，大卫是写这一颗诗篇的人。
And David is the one who wrote the psalm.
他的人生当中遇到很多次的苦难。
Throughout his lives, he had encountered many troubles.
那每次他躲无可躲、逃无可逃的时候
，And each time when he found that there is no hiding place for him.
他很害怕的时候
，When in times of his fear.
他发觉啊，神都在保护他。
He realized that it was God who was protecting him.
我们看二十七章诗篇二十七章的第五节。
Let's turn to Psalm 27 verse 5.
二十七章的第五节。
Psalm 27:5.
请读。
5. For in time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret place of his tabernacle he shall hide me. He shall set me high upon a rock.
这里大卫说啊，当他遇到困难患难的时候。
Here David says that in times of calamity or problems,
人会不会遇到困难
？Will we ever encounter problems?
有时候只是时间的问题而已。
It's only a matter of time.
也许你现在很顺利。
Perhaps everything is well for you.
可能下一分钟你就遇到一个人生最大的困难。
Perhaps in the next minute you shall encounter the biggest problem in your life.
这天气不会永远都晴天的。
The weather cannot always be sunny.
你看我们温哥华前几天还像夏天一样都穿短袖。
Look at Vancouver. Only a few days ago, we're still in shorts and T-shirts.
突然间秋天都没有了，好像直接进到冬天的感觉。
It seems that we have skipped autumn and went directly into winter.
可能还下个礼拜，说不定还下雪。
Next week it might even snow.
人生就是这样。
This is life.
没有永远晴天的。
Nothing stays the same forever.
大卫本来都活得好好的。
And David had a good life.
打败了哥利亚，全国都拥戴他。
He defeated Goliath, the entire nation glorified him.
哥利亚都没有办法威胁他的生命。
Even Goliath could not threaten his life.
没想到是以色列的王扫罗要他的命。
And unexpectedly, it was the king of Israel, Saul, who wanted his life.
有时候要你命的不是你真正的敌人，是你最亲近的人。
Sometimes the people who want you dead are not your enemies, but those closest to you.
有时候要你命的是你帮助过的那个人。
It could be the one you have helped before.
大卫只能逃命。
So all David could do was flee.
有时候真的逃到没有地方逃了。
And when he had no other place to run to,
我们看撒母耳记上的23章。
Let's turn to 1 Samuel chapter 23.
23章14节。
Chapter 23, verse 14.
大卫住在旷野的山寨里，常在西佛旷野的山地。扫罗天天巡朔大卫。这里记载啊，大卫一直逃啊逃啊逃啊。
So here, David kept fleeing from place to place.
从城市逃到乡村。
From the city, he went to the village.
从乡村跑到旷野。
From the villages, he went to the wilderness.
因为人越少的地方，就越难被发现。
Because the less population there is, the easier for him to hide.
扫罗有整个国家的军队。Saul
has the army.
要有全国的百姓都要听他的话，提供情报啊。As
well as the citizens of the nation providing him with information.
可以说是抱下天罗地网。
So it seems that he has spread a really tight net.
抓到大卫只是时间的问题而已。So
to capture David is only a matter of time.
但是很奇妙，他就是抓不到大卫。And
miraculously, he still could not find David.
因为最后一句，神不将大卫交在他的手里。Because
of the last phrase in this verse, God did not deliver him into his hand.
人要害你。If
people want to put you in harm's way.
但是如果神不容许。Yet
if God is unwilling,
如果神不把你交出来,
if God does not deliver you into your enemy's hands,
无论他是一国之君, 他也没有办法害你。
Regardless who your enemy is, they will not be able to harm you.
所以大卫啊, 表面上是躲在山寨里。
So on the surface, David was staying in a stronghold.
其实他是躲在神的里面的, 神把他保护起来啊。
In fact, he was hiding in God. It was God who protected him.
这句话我们每次读到的时候都觉得很宝贵。
Every time we read this verse, we feel that it is very precious.
如果你敬畏神, 你有神同在。
If you fear God, you have the abidance of God.
你不怕全世界任何一个人想要害你。
You do not have to be afraid of anyone on earth.
有一次啊，扫罗快要抓到大卫。There
was once when Saul was almost going to capture David.
我们看26节。
Let's read verse 26.
26节。
Verse 26. Then Saul went on one side of the mountain, and David and his men on the other side of the mountain. So David made haste to get away from Saul. From Saul and his men were encircling David and his men to take them.
这扫罗已经跟大卫是同在同一个山上，好像玩躲猫猫这样子了。
So David and Saul were happened to be on the same mountain, and they seemed to be playing hide and seek.
大卫在山的这一边,
David on one side of the mountain.
扫罗在山的另外一边,
Saul on the other side of the mountain.
差不多要找到他, 差不多要把他围住了。
They were almost going to catch up and almost going to encircle them.
因为大卫, 扫罗已经知道, 他们就在这座山里面。
And Saul knew that David and his men were in this particular mountain.
那很容易抓啊。
So it's easy for him to capture David now.
最紧张的时候,
at the critical time,
神出手了,
God stretched out his hand.
27节,
verse 27.
忽然有使者来告诉扫罗，扫罗啊，扫罗王啊，不得了了，腓利斯人来犯境啊。A
messenger came to Saul and told him that the Philistines had invaded the land.
请王赶快回去打腓利斯人了。And
they're begging the king to return to defeat the Philistines.
你看，这一条鱼都快钓到手了。So
David, being the fish, is almost being caught.
已经在笼子里面了，没有收起来而已。
It is already in the net. It's only a matter of time of dragging the net out of the water.
但是现在不收都不行啊，是要放开啊，要不然他就去对付腓利斯人。But
Saul had to cut the net because he now has a new enemy, the Philistines.
这个不是出于神吗？
Isn't this the work of God?
这里告诉我们一点。
So it tells us one thing.
你生活当中无论遇到任何大小的困难。
No matter how big or small your problem is in your life,
或者是物质上遇到多大的危险,
or how much danger you're in physically,
也许工作上面有人有同事要陷害你，有老板要针对你,
and perhaps at work your boss directs his problems at you, or your coworkers are not happy with you.
你不用怕。
Do not be afraid.
如果神不允许，你不会失去这份工作。
If God does not allow it, you will not lose the job.
有人要出口，要恐吓你，要陷害你。
If someone were to threaten you,
你不用担心,
do not worry.
如果神不把你交出来,
if God does not deliver you,
你一根头发也不会掉地上,
you will not lose even a single piece of hair.
如果你是神要保护的人,
if you are the one that God wanted to protect,
你是走在神道路上面的人,
then you are one who walks on the path of God.
你根本就不用怕,
you don't have to worry.
所以大卫他一早就躲在神里面了,
so David was already hiding in God.
大卫说我没有其他地方可以逃了,
because David claimed that he has no other place to hide.
但是他的心是已经藏在神里面,
the heart of David is already hiding in God.
所以他在最没有安全感的地方, 就有最大的安全感,
so in a place where there is no security, he actually found security.
如果你心里没有安全感,
if you don't feel safe in your heart,
就算你住在最安全的房子, 你也是没有安全感, 也睡不着,
even if you live in the safest place, you still feel insecure.
但是如果里面有100%的安全感,
but if there is security in your heart,
你躲在神的里面,
and you hide in God,
别人说要害你, 要整理, 要修理你,
even if others were to put you in harm's way,
你就让他们去玩吧,
you will say to yourself, let them play.
我在神里面,
because I am in God.
但是问题是你有没有走在神的道路上面?
The question is, are you walking on the path of God?
如果你没有走在神的道路上面,
if you're not,
你就不在神的手中,
then you're not in the hands of God.
大卫他走在神的道路上面,
David has walked on the path of God.
他连扫罗在他手中, 他可以陷害他, 他都不敢陷害扫罗,
even when Saul was handed to David, he would not put Saul into harm's way.
因为他是神的受膏者，不敢乱来啊。
Because David knew that Saul was the anointed one of God.
有一句话叫打狗都要看主人嘛。
There was a Chinese saying that if you want to beat someone's dog, you actually have to look at the master first.
没有错，他是一条狗，但是他后来后面的主人是谁，你知道吗？
It is true that Saul may be a dog, but you have to see who's the master.
他是属于他的神的。
That Saul belongs to God.
他犯罪，神会修理他。
If Saul sinned, God would take care of him.
但是我的刀绝对不可以伤害神的受膏者。
But my knife shall never be put onto the messenger of God.
我的刀砍下去了，神，我都得罪神了。
If I killed the king, then I am sinned. I have sinned against God.
神看重他的心。
And God has placed favor onto David because of his heart.
神不让扫罗的刀伤害到大卫。
And therefore, God does not allow the knife or the swords of David, the swords of Saul to harm David.
所以今天呢，我们遇到任何的困难，任何的危险。
And today, no matter what danger you find yourself in,
你放心，藏在神里面。
Rest assured, hide in the Lord.
你要让你的心藏在神里。
Let your heart hide in God.
但是你要问自己，我有没有神走在神的道路上？
However, you must ask yourselves, have I walked on the path of God?
第二点。
Second point.
藏在属灵的隐秘处什么意思？
To hide in the secrets, to hide in a spiritual secret place, what does it mean?
我们要从口舌的争闹当中隐藏起来。
We have to hide from the strife of tongues.
我们看31章，诗篇31章的20节。
Let's turn to Psalms 31, verse 20.
诗篇31篇20节。
Psalms 31:20. Psalms 31:20, you shall hide them in the secret place of your presence. From the plots of men, you shall keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues.
这里大卫形容啊，我要藏在神的隐秘处里面。
Here, David says that I have to hide in the secret place.
到底要躲藏什么呢？
What is he hiding from?
有时候不是真的是别人的刀啊、剑啊、枪啊那种物质的武器。
Sometimes it's not the physical, the guns or the swords.
有时候真正伤人、真正害人的武器是嘴巴。
Sometimes the weapon that truly kills is the mouth.
是人的诡计。
The plots of men.
所以大卫说：“神啊，我要躲在你的隐秘处里面。”And
that is why David claimed that he wants to hide in the secret place of God.
免得有人的计谋要陷害我。Less
Someone tried to put it in harm's way.
哇，你看大卫他面对扫罗。So
what was David facing?
扫罗嘴巴都讲得很好听。And
Saul had put it very nicely.
每次抓到差不多要抓到，大卫放过他了。他说：“哎呀，对不起，以后我不会再这样了。”
So every time David captured him and released him, Saul would say, "I'm sorry, I won't do it again."
但是下次他又来。Yet
he will repeat the same mistake.
因为他有计谋啊，他整天就想保罗，想要把大卫杀掉。
Because Saul is scheming, and all day he could think about was to kill David.
那你看主耶稣在世上的时候
，and take a look at our Lord Jesus during his ministry.
也遇到很多人的计谋。
He also encountered many schemes of men.
那些法利赛人文士装的假惺惺的说，哦，你好，良善的夫子哦，你真好啊，我要问你一个问题啊。
Those scribes and the Pharisees, they were being hypocrites, and they approached the Lord Jesus saying in a friendly way that they want to ask him a question.
哦，你是良善的夫子啊。
They claim him to be a good teacher.
纳税给该撒可不可以啊？
So good teacher, is it all right for us to pay taxes to Caesar?
是假惺惺的虚假的问题啊，要害耶稣了。
This is a hypocritical question because they want to put Jesus into harm's way.
主耶稣说可以也不行。
If our Lord Jesus said yes, that is the wrong answer.
主耶稣说不可以也不行。
If our Lord Jesus said no, that is still the wrong answer.
哇，这是陷阱啊，计谋啊。
It's a trap. It's a scheme.
哇，很危险啊。
Very dangerous.
所以真正的危险有时候不是刀跟枪的危险。So
true dangers sometimes are not the physical weapons.
是要害你的人。 卸下一些陷阱，用你的话来追击你，打击你。
It's people who are scheming against you, and they're laying a trap to catch you with your own words.
那这个时候怎么办？
So what can you do?
我赶快躲在神里面，求神给你智慧啊。
Hide in the Lord and beg the Lord to give you wisdom.
当时大卫就是这样祷告。
And that was how David prayed at that time.
神啊，你不要让我遇见人的计谋啊。
So Lord, please do not let me face the plots of men.
不要堕下去，不要堕到陷阱里面。
Let me not fall into the trap.
你一掉下去，哦，没完没了了。
Because if you fall into the trap, then there's endless trouble.
有时候你在公司啊、社会上面遇到人讲话，也是要非常小心。
And that is why sometimes at work or in society, you have to be careful what you say.
人家有时候会用你的话去害你。
Because some people would use your own words against you.
有时候呢，还会偷偷帮你录音，因为现在手机每一台手机都可以录音。
And they will sometimes even secretly record your conversations.
你讲过的每一句话，
every word that you speak
都有可能回到你。 来控告你。
It is possible that they will be used against you.
但是你不用怕。
But do not be afraid.
只要你良心对得起神，行在真理里面。
As long as you have a clear conscience, you're walking on the path of God and the truth.
神会保守住你。
And God will protect you.
你不用怕别人的计谋。
You do not have to be worried about the schemes of others.
那这里特别提到的，要求神保守我们，隐藏在神里面，免受口舌的争闹。
And it says here that we should be kept secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues.
哇，这个也是很宝贵啊。This
is a very precious verse.
有时候能够影响我们的是舌头讲话，别人的讲话跟我们的讲话有时候这种冲突，这就叫舌头的争闹。And
sometimes what affects us are the strife of tongues, which means that you and others are in an argument.
这个很可怕。This
is frightening.
有人的地方就有问题。
Because where there are men, there are problems.
你不要说，哦，为什么这里都有人的问题？
Don't ask why are there problems here.
有人就有问题啊，除非没人就没有人的问题。
When there are humans, there are problems. Unless there are no humans, then there is no problem.
那为什么人与人之间有那么多问题？
Why are there so many problems among men?
我们看箴言26章。
Let's turn to Proverbs 26.
第20节。
Proverbs 26:20.
就是这句话，就是把所有人际关系的问题都点出来。
And this verse has pointed out all the interpersonal relationship problems.
一个家庭，一个婚姻，甚至一个团体，一个教会。
At a family, a wedding, an organization, or even a church.
二十节。Verse
20.
火缺了柴，昼必熄灭。
As charcoal is to burn coals and wood to fire.
无人传舍，争竞并止息。
So is a contentious man to strive to kindle strife.
一个火堆啊，你没有给他新的柴，他就烧不下去了嘛。
If there's a pile of wood without fire, it wouldn't burn.
相对的，如果你一直给他新的柴，他就一直烧，还有越烧越大。
On the other hand, if there's a fire going and you put more wood to it, then it will burn even mightier.
那你没有柴啊，就烧不下去了。
Without wood, a fire cannot burn.
这个柴是什么？
What is this wood?
人的舌头。
It's your tongue, a human tongue.
大家都喜欢听八卦，大家都喜欢闲言闲语。
Everybody loves gossips.
啊，来教会不是听真理，喜欢听，哎，最近谁跟谁又怎样。
And people come to church not to listen to the truth, but to listen to the gossips.
啊，有人来教会就问了，我好久没有来教会了，最近教会有什么八卦？ And miss 掉哪？miss 掉几个连续剧啊？
And there's some people who would say that
真的有，不是开玩笑啊。There's
some people, some members who would say that I have missed church for the last few weeks. So what is the latest gossip?
哇，来教会不是我错过了几篇道理，我说错过几篇连续剧，到底最近怎么样啊？
So some people come to church mentioning that they They did not ask how many sermons they have missed, but rather how many episodes of dramas they have missed.
难怪那么多人的问题。
So no wonder we have so many interpersonal problems.
是我们躲在神的隐秘处里面。
So let us hide in the secret place of God.
这里说无人传舍，真竟便止息。无人传舍，真竟便止息。And
it says, if no one, so is a contentious man to kindle strife.
No tale bearer, strife ceases.
Oh, sorry. So if there is no tale bearer, then strife ceases.
你没有家柴了，那个火都没有了嘛。
So if you do not add wood to the fire, it will go out.
所以如果有时候在属灵的团体里面，你看到有口舌的争闹。
So if you see an organization where there are strife of tongues,
教会里面有一些不平安了。 And
there is no peace in the church.
或是你自己家里、家族、家庭里面有一些不平安了。
Or that there are problems in your own family.
可能有人讲很多话，讲太多了。Perhaps
there will be one of them who has spoken too much.
但是人家跟你讲了，你不要听了，你就传出去。But
when others tell you these things, do not listen to it and then spread it out.
你就传来传去，把这个问题弄得更大。Because
if you're to spread it out, you are enlarging the problem.
啊，你每次你自己讲起来，你也是一肚子火，你也是被自己拉下去。Because
if you are to relay these gossips or these problems, then you yourself get angry.
明明是别人的问题，为什么你讲的好像自己的问题一样？Because
this is not your problem, it's somebody else's problem. Why do you take on the responsibility?
你顾好自己的灵性又来不及了，你管别人那么多啊。
The first thing that you should do is take care of your own spirituality.
所以如果有人跟你讲东讲西,
so if someone were to gossip to you,
有人跟你讲别人的问题,
or someone tells you of some other's problems,
你要问对方,
ask that person,
你自己亲耳听见了吗? 你亲眼看见吗?
Did you see this with your own eyes? Did you hear this with your own ears?
还是你听别人讲?
Or did you hear it from someone else?
如果他说, 我听别人讲的。听别人讲,你不要跟我讲。
If they
也不是你亲耳听到,也不是亲眼看到。
If they say, I heard it from someone else, then you have to respond by saying, then don't tell me anymore because it's not from first-hand account.
第二,有人跟你讲,有的没的,别人的事情,你要问他,这个跟我有关系吗?
And if someone were to tell you again these kind of gossips, then you should respond by saying, does this have to do with me?
好像有跟你没关系哦。
It doesn't seem to have anything to do with me.
那没关系，也不要告诉我，我不想听，跟我没有什么关系的事情。
If it has nothing to do with me, don't tell me.
第三，这个东西对我有帮助吗？
Third, is this beneficial to me?
你告诉我这个事情会让我更有信心、更有爱心、更热心吗？
By telling me this, are you going to strengthen my faith?
如果又没有。
If not,
那你为什么要告诉我？
Then why tell me?
我要躲开这些口舌的争闹，我们不想听啊，不想管了。
I have to flee from all this strife of tongues.
听起来好像很消极。
It seems rather passive.
但是总是要有人把这个火熄灭掉。
But someone has to quench the fire.
人没有办法解决的，我们交给神啊。Maybe
humans, we can't do much. We can only ask God to help.
这是主耶稣告诉我们的事情。
So this is what our Lord Jesus tells us.
所以我们口舌的争闹，我们要躲开。
So all these strifes of tongues that we should try to avoid.
尤其是已经开始影响自己的灵性的时候，especially
when it starts to affect your own spirituality.
我们要躲在神里面安静。We
have to hide in the Lord and be quiet.
啊，有时候这个口舌的争闹也会影响我们自己的家人。你有时候自己家人吵架了，也是口舌的争闹啊。Sometimes
these strife of tongues affect our own family because we have arguments in a family.
譬如说一家人。For
example, in one family.
真正发生问题的是什么问题？What
is the real problem that's going on.
常常都是嘴巴的问题。
It's usually the problem with the mouth.
我讲话刺激你，你讲另外一句话来报仇刺激我。
I say something that would irritate you, and you respond with words that would irritate me.
我把我的情绪倒给你，你把你的情绪也倒回来给我。
I pour out all my negative emotions onto you, and in return, you pour your negative emotions onto me.
家里本来是一个放松、很平静的地方。
A family should be a place where you can relax and be yourself.
但是有时候就是忍不住那口气，收不住那个嘴巴。
But yet there are times that we couldn't keep to ourselves that we have to speak these evil words.
所以就是家里都是常常充满了争闹。
And for that reason, the family is always full of contentions.
又改变这个是怎么改变？
To change, how do we do it?
从你自己开始。
It starts from yourself.
有人要开始这个争闹了。
If someone wants to start this quarrel,
甚至有人要无理取闹,
or someone tries to be unreasonable,
甚至有人要伤害, 用嘴巴伤害你,
and one is using words to harm the other,
你心里面一直默祷,
then pray silently in your
主啊,
heart.
我不要给这个火加柴,
Lord, I don't want to add wood to this fire.
我要勒住我的舌头,
I want to bridle my tongue.
我要先忍住。
I have to try to have some patience first.
我要求神给我智慧。
So Lord, please give me wisdom.
当我们躲在神的里面。
When we hide in the Lord.
我们就能够有办法躲过口舌的争闹。
Then we will. Then we now have a plan to run away from this strife of tongues.
尤其是啊，这些争闹啊。第十一页是吧？有时候这争闹是在我们的婚姻里面常常会发生的。
Especially when these strifes happened in your marriage.
有一些时候啊，夫妻啊常常斗嘴啊，吵架。
Sometimes couples argue and fight with one another.
有时候斗得太厉害，什么话都讲出来。
And at times when the argument gets heated up, they will say all sorts of words.
有一些话讲出去你收不回来。
Yet there are some words once spoken you cannot take them back.
对方永远会记住你那句话。
And the party who got hurt will always remember.
甚至有一些话你讲了，说对不起也没有用。
And there are some words that you have spoken, but you cannot take them back.
会造成永远的伤害。
Because they will cause permanent damage.
所以我们要赶快躲在神里面。
And therefore we have to quickly hide in our God.
你想要发泄你的情绪的时候，你赶快祷告，我要躲在你里面，我要逃避口舌的争闹。
If you want to release your anger. Then you should quickly run to the Lord, hide in Him to avoid the strife of tongue.
那怎么样才可以避免口舌的争闹？
How do we avoid strifes of tongue?
啊，有一个方法。
There is one method.
这是下一页所讲的。如果一个人常常被神的话充满，喂饱。
If a person who is filled and full of the Word of God.
啊，对呀，他越来越里面的灵命越来越坚强。
That person has a stronger spiritual life.
他里面有一种平安吗？
And there is peace in him.
别人用话来刺激他，他是不会反应的。
When others use words to prick them, they will have no reaction.
因为他躲在神的恩典里面。
Because they hide in the strife of God.
我再重复一次。
Let me repeat it once again.
一个人你要吃饱神的话，有神的灵在他里面充满他的时候。
And if a person is fed and filled with the words of God.
别人的嘴巴没有办法很容易的去刺激到他。
Then other people cannot easily irritate them.
因为他的情绪已经被神的话包住了，把它沉淀下去，把它锁紧了。
Because their emotions have been covered by the word of God and it's not settled.
情绪是会波动，但是神的话压下去，把它锁住。OK， 就这样。控制住，不要乱动。
Emotions fluctuate up and down, but the word of God can cover them up and firm them.
但是如果你没有被神的话充满，
if you have not been filled with the word of God,
你没有常吃神的话进去，
you have not eat or be fed with the word of God,
你的灵命很幼稚，
your spiritual life is still very immature.
那人家一刺激你，你就会反击。
That when others tend to irritate you, you will want to react.
你就没有办法控制你的舌头。
Because and then you will not be able to bridle your tongue.
你一控制不了，你就跟他一起争闹，两个人就口舌就争闹了。
Once you cannot control yourself or your tongue, then you will cause a quarrel or a strife.
不是这样吗？很多时候为什么吵什么事？到底吵什么？没有什么事嘛。
Isn't that the case? Sometimes when you ask people why they quarrel, they can't give you a very good reason.
情绪而已。
It's all emotions.
但是有神的话在我们的心里。
However, if you have the word of God in you,
你就能够躲避开口舌的争闹。
Then you can avoid these strifes of tongue.
试一试啊，夫妻之间啊，多一起读圣经，多一起讲神的话语。
Try it with your spouse. Read the Bible together.
一起祷告。
Pray together.
神的话在我们心里，我们不一样。
When the words of God stays in your heart, you will feel different.
那口舌的争闹呢，不一定是负面的。
And sometimes the strife of tongue may not be negative.
有时候是正面的。
Sometimes it's positive.
有时候是别人的掌声。
Sometimes it's the applause of others.
你遇到别人的掌声的时候，你也要躲起来。
When you face the applause of others, you have to hide.
我们看马可福音第六章。
Let's turn to Mark chapter 6.
四十五节。
Mark chapter 6 verse 45.
马可六章四十五、四十六节。
Mark chapter 6 verse 45 and 46.
你读。
45. Immediately he made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side, to Bethsaida, while he sent a multitude away. 46. And when he had sent them away, he departed to the mountain to pray.
这里记载主耶稣怎么样躲藏起来。
Here we recorded how our Lord Jesus hid himself.
主耶稣什么时候躲藏起来？
When did the Lord Jesus hide himself?
你看37到44节。
If you read verse 37 to 44.
主耶稣刚刚变饼喂饱了五千人呢。
He had just fed 5,000.
这个是很大的神迹。
This is a miracle.
这是所有神迹里面 involved， 这是有关联最多人的一次的神迹。
This is a miracle that involved the most, the highest number of people.
一次5000多个人领到这个神迹。
It was 5,000 people received this miracle.
哇，这个是动员起来了，整个群众的动员起来了。
It seems that the entire population had been motivated.
大家已经当了，马上当了耶稣的粉丝。如果主耶稣有IG的话，马上 follow 他。
And every, and then all these 5,000 immediately became fans of our Lord Jesus. If they were Instagram fan, they were Lord Jesus' fans had probably increased.
因为想起等一下去哪里，耶稣去哪里，我就跟着去。等一下，有那边有饭吃。
Because they would be thinking where Jesus is going next, I will follow because there will be food to eat.
如果有新闻记者的话，一定会采访耶稣。
And if there were journalists or reporters there, they would want to interview Jesus.
甚至可能有政党的话，会说耶稣要不要加入？哇，你那么受欢迎，那你加入我们的政党，选举你一定赢。
And if there were political parties at that time, they would definitely want Jesus to join their party and to ensure that they will win a seat in the next election.
这个时候应该是主耶稣最多人最受欢迎的时候。
So at this time, it is when our Lord Jesus is the most popular.
那主耶稣去哪里？
But where did Jesus go?
大家讨论他的时候，主耶稣去哪里？
When everyone was talking about him, where did he go?
主耶稣叫门徒上船，自己叫门徒先到伯赛大那边去。
So the Lord Jesus told his disciples to get into the boat and go to Bethsaida.
但是主耶稣没有跟他们上船。
Our Lord Jesus did not get into the boat with his disciples.
连门徒他都不带。
He did not even bring disciples with him.
主耶稣自己上山去祷告。
He went up to the mountain to pray.
哇，这个口舌的争闹有时候是正面的，有时候是赞美啦、关注啦，你的粉丝拥戴你啊。
And sometimes the strife of a tongue could be positive, that is, people who compliment you and praise you and applaud you.
你做完某件事情，大家要鼓励你，要来谈论你。
So after you have done one thing, there are people who want to encourage you, they want to applaud you.
好，这个时候你要怎么做？
So at this time, what do you do?
来来来来，访问我，我来讲讲我的感受。
Come and interview me. I'm willing to share you with my reflection.
哎呀，我来做见证，看看我昨天怎么样变饼的。我告诉大家，听荣耀神啊。
Oh, come to me, and I will testify how I had a miracle of making bread.
听起来都很属灵啊，要做见证，要为耶稣为神做见证。
And it sounds very spiritual to give testimony to the Lord.
主耶稣都不要这些。
But our Lord Jesus didn't want any of this.
主耶稣要躲起来。
Jesus, in fact, wanted to hide.
他知道人的赞美、人的追捧的时候，这是最危险的时候。
He knew that the applause of men at this point would be the most dangerous to him.
他躲在神里面。
He wanted to hide in God.
不要人的这些跟随，还有尊荣。
He doesn't want all these followers and all these glories.
为什么？
Why?
我们看约翰福音第二章。
Let's turn to John chapter 2.
23节。
John chapter 2 verse 23.
约翰二章23节。
John chapter 2 verse 23. Now when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover during the feast, many believed in his name when they saw the signs which he did.
24节。
24. But Jesus did not commit himself to them because he knew all men.
这里说主耶稣不将自己交给百姓。
Here says the Lord Jesus did not commit himself to the people.
那时候很多人信了耶稣嘞。
There were a lot of people who believed in him at that time.
耶稣行了大神迹，谁不信？
Because he had performed a big miracle, so who would not believe in him?
但是24节很宝贵哦，主耶稣没有把自己交给他们。
But take note of verse 24. Jesus did not commit himself to them.
因为他知道万人啊。
Because he knew all men.
人呢，是最靠不住的。
Humans cannot be relied upon.
人比你家里养那条狗还怕靠不住。
And even humans are worse than your pet dog.
我是没养狗，但是我去你们家里都喜欢玩你们家的狗。
I don't have a pet, but every time I go to your house, I like to play with your pets.
那些狗很乖啊，比人还乖啊。
Dogs are well behaved, better behaved than men.
给它吃饭，带它散步，给它去大小便，给它一个地方，它就每次看到你就摇尾巴。
You fed your dog, you play with your dog, you bathe your dog, and every time the dog sees you, the dog will wag its tail.
狗知道谁是主人。
The dog knows who's the master.
对主人很忠心。And
will remain loyal to the master.
但是人呢，哎呀，很难讲啊。But
humans, it's a different story.
你养它，帮它。You
feed them, you help them. You're being nice to them.
哦，他给你拍拍手，很好，你最好，你是全世界最好的。
And they would clap their hands and say, "You're the best in the world."
下一分钟，某一些事情发生了，他可以完全对你做相反的事。
The next minute, when something bad happens, they will do the exact opposite.
你看这些人吃了耶稣的饼。
So take a look at these people. They have eaten the bread of Jesus.
甚至要给耶稣做王啊。And
they even want to hail him as king.
但是过不久了，钉耶稣的就是同一班人。
But not Long after, this is the same group of people who wanted to crucify him.
主耶稣看透人心了。
So our Lord Jesus knew all men.
你欢迎我, 你赞美我, 你支持我, 我根本不要这个。
You welcome me, you applaud me, and you support me. These are not the things I want.
人是靠不住的, 你不要把自己交给人。
Humans cannot be relied upon, therefore, do not hand yourself over to humans.
任何一个人,
any human.
但是你要把自己交给神。
But you have to hand yourself over to God.
因为人的心靠不住，神才靠得住。
Because humans are unreliable, you can only depend on God.
有人给你拍手啊，支持啊，鼓励啊，赞美啊，肯定你的时候，哎，轻轻一笑就走开了，不要多讲了。
So when someone praise you, applaud you, support you, then all you can do is smile and then carry on your way.
根本不要放在心上。
Do not place too much emphasis on these compliments.
反而我们要赶快隐藏起来。
On the other hand, we should immediately hide ourselves.
我们看约翰福音12章。
Let's turn to John chapter 12.
36节。
Chapter 12, verse 36.
约翰12章36节。
Chapter 12, verse 36. 36, while you have the light, believe in the light, that you may become sons of light. These things Jesus spoke and departed and was hidden from them.
你看主耶稣说了这些道理之后。
So our Lord Jesus spoke these words.
哇，那么好的道理。
Such beautiful truth.
他才刚刚坐了驴子进到耶路撒冷啊。
He had just rode on a donkey into Jerusalem.
十二章十二节里面记载得很清楚。
Chapter 12, verse 12, recorded very clearly.
多荣耀啊！
How glorious!
Hosanna, Hosanna! 以色列的王是应当称颂的。
Hosanna, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel.
但是主耶稣知道，不久之后这一批人也要钉他十字架。
Our Lord Jesus knew that not long after, this is the same group of people who want to crucify him.
人的这种欢呼声、赞美声，你也要躲开。
So the cheers and the applause of humans. We should run away from.
如果你是一个属灵人，你一定要躲开。
If you are a spiritual person, you should definitely run away from these.
藏在神里面，神你才是我的交托，你才是我的一切。
You should hide in the Lord because only the Lord is dependable.
别人对你怎么样已经不重要了。
How others treat you is no longer important.
第三点。
Third point.
藏在属灵的隐秘处。
To hide in the spiritual hiding place.
就是你要将你属灵的生命藏在基督耶稣里面。
That is, you have to place your spiritual life, or rather hide your spiritual life in the Lord Jesus.
最宝贵的东西你都要藏在最安全的保险库。
The most precious things that you own must be placed in the safest safe.
你最值钱的东西你不会随便放啊。
Your valuables, you would not place them anywhere.
你可能要去银行开一个保险箱。
You may want to have a safety deposit box in the bank.
你也不会把密码告诉别人。
And you would definitely not tell anyone your code.
有什么东西比你放在保险箱的 珍宝还宝贵。
What is more precious than the valuables in your safe?
是你的灵命。
It is your spiritual life.
但是你的灵命你藏在哪里？
Where are you going to place your spiritual life?
你要藏在基督里。
You have to hide them in Christ.
我们看哥罗西书第3章。
Let's turn to Colossians chapter 3.
3到4节。
Colossians chapter 3, verse 3 and verse 4.
哥罗西书3章3到4节。
Colossians chapter 3, verse 3 and verse 4. For you died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory.
保罗这里说，你们已经死了。Here
Paul says that you died.
旧的我在受洗那一天与主耶稣同死了。The
old you has died with the Lord on the day of your baptism.
那你现在的灵命呢？你现在属灵的生命呢
？Now your spiritual life.
你要把它藏在神里面。You
have to hide them in God.
藏起来。Hide
them.
把最宝贵的心中最宝贵的部分，属灵的生命藏在主耶稣基督里面。
Your most precious, the spiritual, your spiritual life, you have to hide them in Christ.
那藏了就是不明显了。
To hide means that it is not obvious.
但是有一天它会显现出来。But
one day it will appear.
第四节。
Verse 4. For when Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory.
有一天基督耶稣要来了，他显现了。
One day our Lord Jesus will come again when he appears.
我们也要与他一同显现在荣耀里。
We will also appear with him in glory.
你看我们呢，这些信了主的人。
Take a look at us, we Christians.
我们走在街上跟别人没有两样吗？
When we walk on the streets with, we are the same as others.
你在学校，别人也不会觉得你有什么不一样。
When you're in school, no one will feel that you are any different.
大家可能知道你有去教会，你是个基督徒。And
perhaps people know that you go to church, you are a Christian.
但是其他方面，你跟他们没有两样。But
in any other aspects, you are exactly the same.
你要上班、上学、要工作、要赚钱。
You have to go to school, you have to go to work, you have to earn a living.
但是在灵里面，我们跟一般人是不一样的。
However, spiritually, we are different from others.
神就早就把我们藏起来了。
God has already hidden us.
所以我们叫这个灵命跟基督完完全全的连上。
So our spiritual life is connected to Jesus.
其实我们每个礼拜来聚会啊，就是要在神面前把自己的灵命藏在神里面。
And every week we come to the church, we are actually hiding our spiritual life in Jesus.
我们在世界打滚了六天了。
And we have been rolling around in the world for 6 days.
有时候都忘记了主了。
Sometimes we have even forgotten our Lord.
有时候会累啊。
And sometimes we get tired.
有时候迷失了一些方向。
And sometimes we lose our direction.
安息日，安静下来，来到神的面前听道理。
On the Sabbath day, we calm ourselves down and we come before God.
重新得力。
And we regain our strength.
你看，今天应该是大家找不到你的时候。
And today is a day when nobody can find you.
今天安息日应该就是藏在神里面的时候。
Today is a Sabbath day. It is a day you hide in the Lord.
应该你的朋友要找你，现在是找不到你的。
If your friends are looking for you now, they shouldn't be able to find you.
你的手机应该是关起来的。如果你还一边听到了一边回信息，别人还找到你。
Your cell phone should be muted or should be turned off.
如果你有电话，你就跑去接了，那别人还找到你。
If your phone rings and your friends can find you,
你这个安息日，每一个安息日应该是藏在神里面。
And each Sabbath, you should be hiding yourself in Jesus.
别人找不到你，你很心里面很安静。
And said that nobody can find you, and you will feel peace in your heart.
从你踏进教会那一刻
，From the moment you step into the church,
到聚会结束了。
Until the end of the service,
中间你应该完完全全藏在神里面，世界找不到你啊。
And in between then, you should hide yourself completely in the Lord so that the world cannot find you.
世界的烦恼应该找不到你啊。
The troubles of the world should not be able to find you.
世界的引诱应该找不到你。
The temptations of the world should not be able to find you.
哇，这样你就重新得到力量。
Only then you will regain your strength.
现在还不是最艰难的时候。
Now is not the most difficult time.
有一段时候会是更艰难。
There will be a period of time where it is very difficult.
我们看启示录第十二章。
Let's turn to Revelation chapter 12.
十二章十三节。
Chapter 12, verse 13.
十二章十三节。
Chapter 12, verse 13.
龙见自己被甩在地上，就逼迫那生男孩的妇人。
Now when the dragon saw that he had been cast to the earth, he persecuted the woman who gave birth to the male child.
这个就是启示录里面约翰看到一个异象。
So here is a vision seen by John.
他看到一个很大的龙啊。
He saw this big dragon.
这个龙在圣经里面是代表不好的东西啊，是代表魔鬼啊。
Dragon in the Bible represents something not good. It represents Satan.
所以我们信耶稣的人，基督徒啊，不要在家里放什么龙啊、凤啊、一大堆东西啊，这样子当装饰品，这样不好。
So as Christians in our houses, we should not have ornaments of dragons or phoenixes because they're no good.
龙在圣经代表恶者、魔鬼、撒旦。
Dragon in the Bible represents the evil one.
这个意象里面龙。被甩下去。
So the dragon cast to the earth.
因为它在天上已经没有地方了。
Because there's no place for it in heaven.
但是它在地上还是可以活动。
But he can still move around on earth.
好，那这个龙呢，在地上要做什么呢
？And what was this dragon doing on earth?
它要逼迫那个生男孩子的妇人。
He was persecuting the woman who gave birth to the male child.
这个生孩子的妇人是谁
？And who is this woman who just gave birth?
就是神的真教会啊。
It is the true church of God.
就是神的显明，神的儿女。
They are the chosen, the daughters and sons of God.
在主耶稣要来之前。
And before the coming of our Lord Jesus.
魔鬼会对信徒前所未有排山倒海的逼迫、引诱、迫害。
The devil will persecute Christians like never before.
当然，那个时候可能有一些刀啊，有流血、啊，有人要为主舍命的这种迫害。
And of course, in those days, there may be some Christians who would martyr for the Lord.
但是我看呢，不单只是那个时候才有迫害。
But I believe the persecution will not happen only then.
现在已经开始了。
Even now, it's starting.
因为这个迫害，你看下去。
Because if you're to read on.
我们看第十四节。
Verse 14.
于是有大鹰的两个翅膀，是给妇人，叫她能飞到旷野，到自己的地方躲避那蛇。那她在那里被养活一载、二载、半载。
14. But the woman was given two wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness to her place, where she is nourished for a time and time and times and half a time from the presence of the serpent.
啊，那这里说啊，到底要怎么躲
？So how do we hide?
我们先来看第十五节，看这个蛇是这个龙的厉害。
So let's read verse 15 about the serpent.
这个蛇其实是龙一样的东西，都是魔鬼。
The serpent is actually the dragon, which is the evil one.
这个蛇要在妇人的后面呢。吐出一些水，好像河一样。
And the serpent would spill water out of his mouth like a flood after the woman.
将妇人冲去,
he might cause her to be carried away. In fact, this persecution has already started now.
这个不是刀剑, 物质的逼迫,
this is not a persecution physically of weapons.
是属灵的逼迫,
it is a spiritual persecution.
什么叫属灵的逼迫?
What does it mean, a spiritual persecution?
龙啊,或者蛇啊, 它口中吐出来的水啊, 这是世俗的潮流啊。
That the water flowing, spewing out of the mouth of the serpent are the trends of the world.
你看现在的年轻人,
take a look at the young ones today.
跟我们小时候的时代有什么不一样?
How different is it from the time that we were young?
一个手机在手,
with a cell phone in the hand.
下个网路,
connecting to the internet.
随时全世界哪一个地方流行什么东西, 全部掌握住。
And they will be able to have a handle of what's the latest in the world.
以前没有网络的时代,
and before, when there is no internet,
你这个地方流行的, 在世界另外一个地方不会马上跟得上。
That one thing that is trendy in one place of the world will not immediately affect the other place.
但是现在有了网络,
now with internet,
所有东西变成一个潮流, 这全球性的。
When one thing becomes a trend, it becomes a trend globally.
全世界的青少年喜欢什么音乐, 大概都是那一些。
And what kind of music do the young ones like these days? It's the same everywhere.
你不是北美洲听这些啊, 东南亚的孩子也是听这些啊。
It's not just the children in North America, even the ones in Southeast Asia are listening to the same music.
你看那些 Netflix 的show啊, 非洲孩子啊, 或者是印度那些也在看的这些啊。
And the Netflix,
只有你的网络啊。
The Netflix shows that you watch here, the kids in India and also in Africa are watching the same thing as long as they have the internet.
Social media, 社交媒体所传的东西啊。
And everything that goes on in social media,
所有人都在看,
everyone is reading them.
这个就是龙的嘴巴的水啊,
these are the waters spewing out from the mouth of the dragon.
已经在迫害我们了, 已经在逼迫我们了,
it has already started persecuting us.
它那种资讯的量, 每天大家被这种资讯来喂啊, 喂到你塞饱了, 还是停不下来。
And these information, volumes of these information are feeding us every day.
手机停不下来啊, 滑不停啊。
And we cannot stop, keep flipping our cell phones.
小孩这样, 大人这样。
The children as well as the adults.
有一天我在开车,
there was one day when I was driving.
啊, 在红绿灯停下来。
I stopped at the traffic light.
左边那台车,
the car to my left.
哦, 那个司机也在滑手机。
The driver was looking at his cell phone.
右边那台公车,
the bus on my right.
我很久没有坐公车,
I haven't been on a bus for some time.
我看看公车里面所有人在做什么,
I was looking at the passengers in the bus.
哇, 全部在低头,
they will all have their heads down.
除了没有手机的人, 没有几个, 阿婆都在低头,
other than the ones,
阿公都在低头,
other than the ones without cell phones, even the seniors are
大家很专注,
on the bus are looking at their cell phones.
你这个时候在他面前做什么, 他都不会发觉你在做什么。
And at this time, whatever you do before them, they won't notice.
大家都在被这个世界, 这个水啊, 冲啊, 冲啊, 被他冲啊, 被他喂饱啊。
So everyone has been carried away by this flood from this water that came out from the serpent.
这个不是一种逼迫吗?
Isn't this another kind of persecution?
不是一种资讯的逼迫吗?
Isn't this information persecution?
不是停不下来吗?
That we can't stop.
没有办法停下来, 没有办法专注。
We can't stop, we can't focus.
所以你说要他们听道理啊, 讲那么久, 讲50分钟那么久啊, 现在的短片 5秒钟都太长。
And that's why people can't sit still for a 50-minute sermon. Even today, there are people who cannot even stand a 5-second clip.
以前还有人做5分钟的video, 现在5分钟的谁来看? 5秒钟。 勉勉强强了，给你五秒了啊。There
are people who used to make 5-minute clips. Even then, it's considered long. Now it's down to 5 seconds.
你看，我们不是在一直被冲了吗？
So aren't we being carried away by the flood?
好累啊。
Tiring.
但是这个时候，我们不要被冲走。
But let us not be carried away.
我们再看回来, 怎么样来躲在神的隐秘处里面?
So how should we hide in God's secret place?
14节啊,
Verse 14.
有大鹰的两个翅膀。
Two wings of a great eagle
赐给妇人,
was given to the woman,
叫她能够飞到旷野,
that she might fly into the wilderness,
到自己的地方,
to her place.
弟兄姐妹,
brothers,
我们是神的选民啊。
Brothers and sisters, we are the chosen ones of God.
这个世界不是我们自己的地方啊。
This world does not belong to us.
我们暂时在这边而已。
We are here temporarily.
但是你不逃到旷野, 你是躲避不了的。
But if you don't run to the wilderness, you will not be able to hide.
神要给你翅膀, 超越。
God wants to give you wings so that you can elevate yourself.
你有这个鹰的翅膀，地上的水里就冲不到你了。
With this wings of the eagle, that the floods of the world will not carry you away.
你要过一个超越的生活。
You have to live a life surpassing the world.
我每个礼拜要飞到教会，我怎么样忙，我整天安息日我要给神。
So every week we have to fly ourselves to the church, regardless of how busy we are.
手机要关下来，不要上网，不要。 看一下我的美人,
and let us turn off our cell phones so that we don't look at the internet.
好好跟弟兄姐妹团契,
let's have fellowship with brothers and sisters. Let's pray to God.
每天回到家里了,
every day after we go home,
给神15分钟好不好?
Can you give God 15 minutes?
手机电脑,
and just get yourself away from your cell phones and your computer.
安安静静打开圣经,
to have a quiet place to read the Bible.
最好是纸本的圣经。
It's best that you have a paper copy.
因为你用 iPad, 你等下叮咚起来，你要看别的。
Because if you use an iPad and there is notification come up, you will then change your window.
你跪在神的面前。
Kneel before God.
隐藏在属灵的隐秘处。
To hide in the spiritual hiding place.
好好跟神讲话。
To have a good conversation with God.
这样你才有办法躲避这些世界的烦扰啊。
Only then you're able to run away or to hide from the troubles of the world.
将你的灵命才把藏在主耶稣基督里面。
Only then you're able to hide your spiritual life in the Lord Jesus.
今天你有没有躲在神的里面？
Today, have you hide in the Lord?
有没有躲在属灵的隐秘处？
Have you hide in the spiritual hiding place?
唱诗。
Let's sing him.
344首。
Number 344.